Meteorologist Malachi Rogers is here at the desk with me. Malachi, a lot of severe weather the past couple of days. How long is it going to stick around?
Some intense storms, a lot of lightning, some wind damage out there, but no severe thunderstorm warnings. Amazing that we had a week like that, and we'll see that same setup tomorrow, but by Tuesday, things start to change, and I think we're all looking forward to that. In fact, we're going to see a drier weather pattern set up for the week ahead. Outside right now, Daytona Beach, always a popular spot, 76 degrees is our temperature, and our overnight lows are going to fall probably another 3 to 4 degrees when you wake up on Monday morning. So temperature is up 80 degrees at Cocoa right now, 77 in Melbourne and Leesburg, 73 in Ocala, and 75 right now in Titusville. We are socked in with the clouds, but the good news is that all the rain has come to an end. It's actually pushing offshore. We start early on your Monday morning, 9 a.m., folks back to work. Things are partly cloudy, warm, but calm tomorrow morning. By noon, we'll see a few isolated showers trying to work their way in. This is our East Coast sea breeze trying to make its presence felt. It will push slowly inland at about 10 to 15 miles an hour. By about 2 o'clock, it looks like the better rain chances line up right along I-4. And from there, the East Coast sea breeze pushes back to around I-75, where it encounters the West Coast sea breeze, and that's where we'll see our most dramatic storms, our heaviest lightning, and our heaviest rainfall. So keep that in mind for your plans tomorrow. So out the door tomorrow morning with temperatures in the mid and low 70s. Make sure you grab that umbrella before you head out the door. Tomorrow afternoon, we warm up rapidly. We start at 74. We're up to 88 degrees by noon. Keep in mind, the last couple of mornings, we've started out mainly sunny. Don't let that fool you when you head out the door tomorrow morning, because by tomorrow afternoon, we will still be dealing with some showers and storms in the forecast. High temperatures tomorrow will stay upper 80s to near 90 degrees along the shoreline. As we move inland, temperatures expected to climb to the low 90s. 92, 93, not out of the question, but an active afternoon with thunderstorms once again on your Monday. But after Monday, things start to dry off just a bit. Part of the reason we've had so much rainfall is a lot of moisture associated with the little stationary boundary just to our north. It's not really a boundary, but it's just a focus area where showers and storms have developed. By tomorrow, that gets pushed back to the west, far enough away from us that it's not going to be that area to generate those enhanced thunderstorms. So we'll just see our garden variety afternoon sea breeze collision storms as we head towards Tuesday and Wednesday. What does that mean? That means instead of rainfall chances like we saw over the weekend, 60, 70%, our rain chances by Tuesday go down to 30 and even 20%. Quick stop, though, in the tropics. Here we are in Orlando. We're going to zoom all the way down to Puerto Rico, where there's a little tropical wave, very disorganized, but it's producing some rainfall and heavy wind gusts. All of that is actually going to pass to our south by midweek. And behind that, we are talking sunshine, warm temperatures for the week ahead. Rain coverage tomorrow around 50%, down to 20 and 30%, Craig, for the rest of the week.